Hola, buenos días y bienvenidos a mi canal Learning Spanish with Señora Ramírez. In this video today, we are going to talk about some tips so you can be successful on OutSchool. And these tips actually come from veteran OutSchool teachers. Recently, I started a Facebook page for OutSchool teachers to advertise their classes and also if they have YouTube videos about OutSchool, they can also post those YouTube videos on this Facebook page. Well, one day I decided to ask everybody, the group members, if they would give us advice for our new OutSchool teachers that were part of the group, for any new OutSchool teachers. And several of them did, and so I want to let you know what they said. And as I point out each piece of advice, I will also give a shout out to that teacher, letting you know what she teaches on OutSchool or what she had to say as her piece of advice for new OutSchool teachers. So the first one, the first tip that we're going to talk about comes from Rebecca, and she says, after a student takes a class with you, especially a one-time class, send a note personally inviting them to a specific second class. Include a link so that they will be able to find it easily. This coincides with the second tip that I have for you, and it is from Noelle Soraya, and she says, build a staircase of classes. Have a place for your students to go once they are finished with your class. I think that is a very good idea. There's this idea called funneling, where you use social media to advertise your classes, whether it be YouTube, Instagram, Facebook. And you can also do it inside your OutSchool class, because when you are listening to class, they actually give you an option to suggest the next class. And if you have a staircase of classes, like Noelle said, to offer, then you will always have something to offer that student to come back and take your classes. All right, the next piece of advice is from Serena Cooper. And Serena Cooper teaches preschool classes, and she also is a history buff. And you can find history classes on OutSchool taught by her. And she says that you should learn the OutSchool optimization for your class. And what I think she means by this is learn the keywords that parents are putting in when they are searching for classes, and make sure that you incorporate those keywords into the titles of your OutSchool classes, because that way your classes will show up first or maybe second in line ahead of the other teachers' classes. And this is a really good tool. I know YouTubers use this when they are trying to decide the titles of their videos, and you can do the same thing with the titles of your OutSchool classes. So you definitely want to keep in mind that the optimization for your classes, the titles of your classes. Okay, the fourth piece of advice is from Laura Reyes, and she says that you should find your niche. And I do agree with her. I do think that you need to find your niche, but I think as a new OutSchool teacher that you also need to experiment. If there are three or four different topics that you are passionate about and that you are an expert in, you can try doing classes in all of those topics and see which ones become the most popular. I teach Spanish, and that's the only kind of classes I have on OutSchool, but I also love to crochet, and I would not be opposed to creating a class about crocheting and teaching it, especially to students between the ages of, I don't know, I was crocheting when I was five. I started when I was five. So anywhere from 5 to 15, it's really fun to do, and a lot of students like it. So even though crocheting has nothing to do with Spanish, it still might be popular on the OutSchool platform. So I'm not opposed to trying it one day. And if you're a new OutSchool teacher, I would definitely experiment with all the things that you're good at, create classes about them, put sections out there and see what hits, see what gains the attention of other students. And the last piece of advice for this video, it comes from me, and it is make sure that you advertise your classes on social media, whether it be Instagram, Facebook, OutSchool groups, YouTube, TikTok, Pinterest. All of those are ways to get your name out there. My favorite is Instagram because I love the community. You can do the stories. It's super quick to do a little video or even just to post something about your classes. And as you get a following, people like to see the same person that has something interesting to say that day. You get, like, I have certain people that I love to follow, and I've found them just by watching Instagram stories. I think that they're fun to watch. They have interesting advice and things that we can implement into our classes. So, and then the community of teachers on Instagram is huge, and it's very positive. It's the theme of helping each other out instead of competing with each other. Community over competition. That's very big on Instagram platforms. So if you haven't advertised your classes yet, or if you've only used one or the other, consider trying a new platform. I don't advertise on TikTok. I don't have a TikTok account, but I know teachers that do, and I know other entrepreneurs that do, and why not? If it gets exposure to your classroom, there are moms on TikTok, and they want their children to learn new things, so it'll funnel learners into your classrooms. The Facebook groups, they're really good. I like them. I especially like being able to interact with the other teachers that are on the Facebook groups, but not everybody is on Facebook. When I started my Facebook group, I invited some of my Instagram teacher friends to join it, and some of them were like, I'd love to, but I'm not even on Facebook. So it's better to try out all of the different social medias and just see what kind of response you get. It definitely can't hurt. Anyway, that is all for today, guys. I hope this video brought you some value. I hope these tips help you out. I hope you get tons of learners in your classes. You just keep going, don't give up. And please, if you haven't done yet, hit that subscribe button, hit the like bell, and I will see you in the next video. Hasta luego.